Hey everyone, Mike from Macworld, and if you're watching this video, you have one thing on your mind, the new iPhone. And I'm here to tell you everything I've heard about it so far. It's iPhone season and Apple's event is just around the corner, and as always, rumors are flying everywhere. So let's get right into it. First, let's talk about the design. Unfortunately, if you're looking for something new, you're not gonna get it. Rumor has it that the iPhone 11 is gonna look a whole lot like the iPhone 10 and the iPhone XS that came before it. So when it comes to the display, that means that's gonna look pretty much the same too. There'll probably be some tweaks to the optimizations, but we're gonna have OLED on the top two models, LCD on the iPhone XR replacement. Really good screens, but essentially the same thing. Around the back, things are looking a little bit different. Apple is rumored to be using matte or frosted glass instead of glossy glass, so it might be a little less fingerprint prone, and some rumors have suggested it might be a little less breakable too, which is a good thing. There's also rumors of new colors, and it's been floated that dark green and maybe lavender is in the mix. Personally, I'd like to see Apple add something to that top tier that's more than just the standard black, white, and gold to add a little spice and color to it like they did with the XR last year. The biggest visual change on the iPhone 11 is going to be the camera. On the XS and the XR, we have that small little array in the top left corner. It's vertically mounted and it's kind of not really all that noticeable. That's changing, and Apple is bringing this big, giant, square camera array to all three models. So inside that new square array is going to be a whole new camera system. On the upper models, the XS and XS Max replacement, there's gonna be three lenses. The standard lens, the telephoto lens, which is going to be possibly 3x up from 2x, and a new ultra-wide lens for capturing more of a scene, landscapes, things like this. In addition to that, Apple is also working behind the scenes on computational stuff to improve low light photos, to get higher resolution, better HDR. And this is where I think the iPhone 11 is gonna truly set itself apart from the other models. We've been watching companies like Google and Samsung and Huawei really kind of blow us away with computational stuff. And based on the rumors and based on this new camera array, which is a big jump, Apple looks to be really getting into this game and just diving in and, you know, just killing it. And in the XR replacement, it's gonna be two lenses. It's gonna look the same, it's still gonna have that big square array, but you're basically getting the camera that's in the XS and the XS Max this year. So you'll get better portraits and better pictures all around. But if you want that triple camera, you're gonna have to spend a little more money. Around the front, Apple is rumored to be making a big jump there too, going from 7 megapixels to 12 megapixels, which will help with selfies and with FaceTime. And also in that front notch, Apple is rumored to be giving the whole True Depth system an upgrade. So Face ID will be that much easier. It's gonna have a multi-angle and a wider field of view. So if your phone is lying on a table, it'll be able to unlock without you kind of, you know, hovering over it. Apple's also rumored to be upgrading the water resistance in the new phones, particularly on the upper models. Right now, all three have IP68 resistance, which means they're resistant to dust and debris, and you could dunk them in about 5 feet of water for about 30 minutes. With the new phones, the rumor says that they'll be significantly better than that. I don't know what the numbers will be, but maybe you'll be able to take them diving. I mean, who knows? One thing that's probably going away on the new iPhones is 3D Touch. It's been around for a couple years, and what you do is you use it to kind of press on the screen a little bit harder to bring up menus and things like this. To replace it, Apple is adding Haptic Touch, which brings a vibration system to kind of mimic the things that you used to do with 3D Touch. So all those things are gonna stay, it's just a little bit different way of doing it. Personally, I don't think anyone's gonna miss it. Another new feature Apple is reportedly adding to the iPhone 11 is reverse wireless charging. What this means is you'll be able to flip over your iPhone and actually turn it into a charging pad. You can put another iPhone or your AirPods case on it and it'll start charging that. Speaking of charging, Apple will also reportedly be adding more battery in this year's iPhone, up to maybe 25% more on the iPhone XS Max replacement. This is something we've been asking for years, and I'm hoping we get like an extra 2 or 3 or 4 more hours out of it. And of course, Apple is also bringing a new processor to this year's iPhone. It'll be called the A13 something, and it'll be faster and have better graphics as expected. But rumors also say that there's going to be a new coprocessor that handles math-heavy tasks like computational photography stuff and AI stuff. It's similar to the neural engine that Apple has now, but it could really help boost photographs and Siri recognition and things like this. And one more rumor I'm not quite sure I believe is Apple Pencil support. Now, it makes sense for Apple to pull the Apple Pencil from the iPad to the iPhone, but rumor has it that it's going to be making a shorter Apple Pencil specifically for the iPhone. Now, I'm not sure that Apple would do something like that, but I'm intrigued, and it does sound like a cool idea. And lastly, let's talk about the name. We've been assuming Apple would just call this the iPhone 11, the iPhone 11 Max, and the iPhone 11 R. That might not be the case. The latest rumors suggest that Apple will be bringing the Pro name from the iPad and the Mac over to the iPhone for the first time. That means it would be the iPhone 11 Pro, the iPhone 11 Pro Max, and the iPhone 11, which would replace the iPhone XR that exists now. So that's what we know so far, but there's still time for our last minute rumors and spy shots and leaks and whatever else, and maybe a few surprises at the event itself. So stay tuned to Macworld.com for all the latest developments.